Today, our verse is 2 Maccabees chapter 7, verse 2. One of them, acting as their spokesman, said, "What do you intend to ask and learn from us? For we are ready to die rather than transgress the laws of our fathers." Today we have another story of the Jews who refused to comply with the king's order to defy themselves and their religion. Chapter 7 tells the story of the martyrdom of a mother and her seven sons. They were tortured in order for them to renounce their faith. Their faith taught them to uphold certain laws, the laws of circumcision, observe the Sabbath, and avoid unclean food and food sacrificed to idols. At some point, their mother had to intervene to encourage them to hold on to their faith, not to give it up. Their faith was rooted in the resurrection. They believed that even if they die, they will rise again. Our verse today is at the very beginning of the story. The first verse says, "It happened also that seven brothers and their mother were arrested and were being compelled by the king under torture with whips and cords to partake of unlawful swine's flesh," that is pork. The king and his officials knew that it was against the Jewish practice to eat pork, but they wanted to compel them to demonstrate their authority. One of the boys spoke on behalf of the others. "What do you intend to ask and learn from us? We are ready to die rather than transgress the laws of our fathers." They knew the law and were ready to stand for it. So first thing is to know the law, to know what is right, and then to stand for it and do it. They could not go against the laws handed down to them by Moses. How often do those in power today want to compel Christians to do things contrary to their faith? Some governments make laws contrary to our Christian beliefs. Some of those in parliament or government making these laws are Christians. How do we respond as a Christian body? Some rules may be made in your office that is not in line with your Christian faith. Are you able to stand up or risk losing your job? I remember an experience years ago when I was organizing a particular sporting event for my institution. I was soliciting for sponsorship and a particular company offered to sponsor my program on the condition that I accept distributing condoms during the event. I couldn't agree to their terms, and they declined to sponsor our event. We face these challenges more and more today in a secularized world. How are you coping and responding? Or are you giving in to the pressures? Lord, help us stand up to those things that threaten our faith. Please give us the grace to decide for you, even when it may be painful. Amen. God bless you. Enjoy the rest of the day.